Hello, you're stuck with Travis Wolf, Gorlick, a few minutes riffing on IT and IT security. Today, looking at laptop theft. Controls around laptop theft. Why? Why? Because A, it happens all the time, and B, it's a great way to explain controls. You know, oftentimes in these videos, I'm like, hey, you need to put in controls. I'm giving a talk. I'm like, we need controls. Hanging out with some folks, I'm like, where should be controls? And people are like, what? What are you talking about, Wolf? Do you mean like a setting? Do you mean like some software? What are you even getting at? So today I'm going to look at laptop theft and walk through how controls will be applied. And this is particularly important because number one way that like healthcare data, for example, gets breached, if you go up on the websites and look, is it's on a laptop. Laptop gets stolen. So tip for you, there's a million and one different controls that you can put in place to protect a laptop. And this is a very real thing. I was at a hotel room at a conference many years ago, came back to the hotel room, laptop gone. Evil maid attack. Actual evil maid attack. Dang, bless it. And of course, there's long been reports about wand attacks. If you haven't heard about this, the basic concept is criminals have a wand. You're like, hey, I will secure my laptop in the trunk. And the criminals sweep the parking lot, sweep the street with the wand, and they're looking for signals, right? So someone beaconing for Wi-Fi or someone beaconing for Bluetooth. And they're like, ah, this car has a laptop. And they break the glass and they steal the stuff. I was just actually talking to someone this week who this very same thing happened with his couple of his devices. So that last one is not incredibly common. It's more likely someone just sees it or it's left in a coffee house, but you see what I'm saying. What kind of controls can we put in place? Well, obviously the number one control is don't have a laptop or completely avoid the risk, or don't bring the laptop with you, completely avoid the risk. That is not oftentimes the best approach, obviously, because I want a laptop and I have stuff to do. And so that's not going to work. Next one is, if it's in the car, put it in the trunk. That's a control that mitigates risk. As we talked about a minute ago, though, they've got a wand, not completely mitigates the risk. So part two of that is a process. Put it in the trunk and turn it off, right? Put it in airplane mode, turn it off, put it in the trunk. Pretty good. Now, those are the type of controls. The last couple are things that reduce the likelihood of this happening. Now, it may still happen. So what do you do? What kind of controls can you put that would, even if it happened, mitigate the impact of that breach? Well, you can do things like disk encryption. Great, I got my disk encrypted. But, much like saying, okay, I put my computer in the trunk so it's secure, but wait, I left Wi-Fi open and Bluetooth beaconing and someone found out the wand. But just because you have disk encryption doesn't necessarily mean you're safe. If you leave it in a cafe and it's still turned on, if it's in your bag but it's in hibernation mode, in those particular cases, the disk isn't actually, encryption doesn't work, right? Encryption only works when the system is completely powered off and you're booting up and then it's being decrypted. So you also need a supporting control to make sure that not only is it encrypted, but it's always turned off in the event that it gets stolen. And if it's in a risky place, you've also turned it off. Sub-control to handle, to compensate for that. Now, another way to do this is, of course, remote wipe, so-called LoJack systems, that should a device be stolen and it calls home, a beacon goes out and completely wipes the drive. That's another way. Another control that you could add to ensure that should a device be stolen, that the data doesn't get out there, right? The impact in terms of breach doesn't occur. You still have loss from replacing the device, but you don't have to worry about breaching it. So there's a number of different things that we can add across this whole path, right? You can prevent it altogether, you can reduce the likelihood, or you can reduce the impact. And those types of controls oftentimes are behavior. And each one of those types of controls has a likelihood of being missed. So you have a compensating control. Now, if you're an auditor, you're like, okay, now do you have a procedure for that? Are people trained in that procedure? Do you have evidence that they routinely shut it off and that's disk encrypted. I mean, you can go many, many, many layers deep, right? There's many layers you can add to this. But in effect, when we're talking about controls, we're looking at those types of activities and configurations that prevent, reduce the likelihood or reduce the impact of a threat happening. How about you get a laptop stolen? Have you ever really seen one of these wands? I've heard of them, but I've never actually seen one. Either one of those, hit me up in comments or social media. Cheers.